Our next topic is just a bunch of different Python features that will help you in developing your projects and doing your homework. Okay, so I'm going to start up Python. Now, one thing we haven't really discussed much since the first day is how operators work, such as plus or times. Well, the truth is that exactly how they work is kind of complicated, and so we're going to delay that discussion until later in the course. For now, just think of them as being shorthand for calling built-in functions such as add and mul. So this is the same thing as from operator import add mul. And the using infix operators like this does obey the precedence rule. So times comes before addition. If we want to translate that into a call expression, we have to work it out ourselves. So we have to know that this is equivalent to adding 2 to the result of multiplying 3 and 4, and then adding 5 at the end. Now you can use parentheses if you want in expressions that include infix operators in order to change the precedence or override the standard precedence. So this would do the addition first, and then multiply together the two results, 5 and 9. And you can likewise express that by saying multiply, add 2 and 3, and add 4 and 5. Okay, so operators just behave like built-in function calls. Enough of this addition, multiplication stuff. Let's get serious. Let's talk about division. So there are two kinds of division. You can divide. This is called true division, and it uses the slash. Or we can do what's called integer division, which only gives the number of times that the divisor goes into the dividend, not including any remainder. So we lost the 0.3. These have corresponding functions from operator import true div and floor div, the first and the second. So I got true div 2013-10, and I'll get 201.3, or I can floor div 2013, and I'll get the 201. What about the 3? Well, we can get the 3 as well with what's called the mod operator. So this says what's the remainder of dividing 2013 by 10, and that will be 3. And there's a corresponding function. Okay, why do we want these integer, division, and mod operators? Well, they are exact. Whereas you only get an approximation if I say 5 divided by 3, I get 1.66667, when really I should have sixes forever. But it's more exact to say that if I divide 5 by 3, well, 3 only goes into 5 once, and the remainder is 2. Oh, sorry, the remainder of dividing 5 by 3 is 2. Okay, so we'll use those occasionally in the course to break apart numbers, so it's good to know how they work. Here's another feature of Python, is that just as I can assign multiple values to multiple names using one assignment statement, I can also return multiple values from a function. And you'll do this once in your project. So let's say I want both the quotient and the remainder to come back when I divide n by d. Then I can define a function divide exact n by d, which will return not only the result of dividing n by d, but also the remainder. Then I can assign to the quotient and the remainder the result of dividing exactly 2013 by 10. And now quotient is bound to 201 and remainder is bound to 3. Cool. Okay, so far throughout the lectures, I've only been using the interactive Python interpreter. It's a really nice way to play with ideas. But if you want to write something permanent, you usually do it in a file. So I have a file over here, edited with the Vim editor. There are several different editors. that you can use. Look at lab one and it will give you an overview of the different options. Okay, so what happens here is I start typing Python source code and it won't get evaluated or executed until I ask Python to do so. So let's see, it's a good idea to put some text at the top saying what this file is, our first Python source file. Next, you can just start defining functions with def statements. Divide exact n by t is going to be return. We want floor div nd, and then we want mod nd. Oh, I just noticed that I forgot to import these things. Well, I can just do that now. Now, none of this has been executed yet. The way we execute it is that we go back into our shell, we type Python 3, and then the name of the file, this file is called ex.py, ex.py, and it gets executed. Nothing really happened. So why is that? Well, we have just a def statement, which binds the name divide exact to a newly created function, but otherwise doesn't give us any output. Okay, so if instead I go over here and I say q, r equals divide exact 2013 by 10, and I save that, and I execute it, still nothing happens. But if I finally print something out, the quotient is q, the remainder is r. I save that, and I execute it, then I'll actually get some useful output. Okay, so what have we learned? Well, we've learned that we can type Python into files, and we can execute it in this way. Now, a more typical thing is not to have a bunch of print statements in our Python file, but instead, run Python 3 in the interactive mode, first executing some file. So now we've executed this entire file, and then we have an interactive prompt, which means we can now look at Q and look at R, or call divide exact. All right, now when you write functions in a Python source file, you don't typically just give them a name and a return statement. In addition, you give them some documentation about what they do. Return the quotient and remainder of dividing n by d. So there's a convention of using capital, all caps letters to refer to the formal parameters. You don't have to follow this, but we do it in our projects. Okay, so we give some documentation. That's called a docstring. It's the first line below the def line in a def statement. In addition to just describing for humans what this does, we can also show some examples of how it works. I'm going to get rid of this too. And I'm going to put it up here. So I can say, here's what would happen. If you called divide exact on 2013 and 10, and you had bound those to Q and R respectively, and then you looked up Q, you should get 201. And when you look up R, you should get 3. Now this is still just documentation. Everything in here is not Python code. It's just one big string that tells you how this is supposed to work. But within it, I have an example interactive session, and I can simulate that session by typing Python 3-m doctest and then the name of the file. Now, if everything does what it's supposed to do, you'll see no output. If you'd like to see more output, you can pass the -v option, which will tell you everything that happened. So it actually did all of these things that I told it to do. It tried to assign Q and R to the result of divide exact. It expected nothing to follow that, and that was true. And then we evaluated Q, got 201, evaluated R, and we got 3. And if, for instance, I put some error in here, then if I run the same thing, I will see a lot of stars telling us that something went wrong. Failed example, R is expected to be 2. Instead, I got 3. So these are called doctests, and they're run by invoking the doctest module on a particular file. It's a good idea to try that when you're doing your homework. Okay, one last feature. When you're defining a function, you can give what are called default values. So this is not an assignment statement. This is instead a placeholder for a default value that I put after a formal parameter. And what this says is, if there's no argument passed in to be bound to D, then I'll bind 10 to D instead. Which means I can, Python 3-i x.py, run this interactively. If I qr equals divide exact 2013 with no second argument, then it will fill in 10 as the second argument. And I'll get q is 201 and r is 3. We'll use these in our project a little bit as well.